complicated. The humorous detective show Riptide runs on NBC right before The Last Precinct, a time slot it was moved to after losing in the ratings to ABC's Moonlighting. Tonight, Riptide pays homage to the show that knocked it off and pokes a little fun at Moonlighting and at itself. In tonight's episode, the Riptide Detective Agency is hired as technical advisors for a program similar to Moonlighting. Got it? Here's a clip.
Rosalind Grant, Kerry Russell, meet the men of the Riptide Detective Agency of King Harbor.
Hi, how are you?
How are you?
Yeah, for the next 7 days, I'm going to show you what being a real private eye is really like.
Excuse me, there is one thing I don't understand. I thought you said that this series was about two struggling detectives who can barely make ends meet, right?
Yeah, isn't that novel?
Well, how can you afford such nice clothes? I don't understand that. And also this office, I mean, it must cost a fortune to rent and furnish a place like this.
Hey, come on. You think people in Nebraska want to watch a show about people who dress like slobs and live on a boat? Hey, give me a break.
Still to come on Showbiz Today, we'll review Social Security on Broadway and Wise Guys in the movie theaters.
Next week, we'll look at the proliferation of TV weddings. All that and more on Showbiz Today.
And now back to Showbiz Today on CNN.
Some items in the Showbiz databank. Frank Sinatra says he sent a telegram to President Reagan congratulating him on the bombing of Libya. Sinatra says the telegram simply read, "Encore, encore, encore." You got 7 words left, Frank. MTV premieres Hands Across America video tomorrow as part of the project's National Sign-Up Day. Those who want to be part of the coast-to-coast human chain on Sunday, May the 25th, can sign up by calling toll-free 1-800-USA-9000. Senator Paul Simon is introducing legislation intended to encourage the TV industry to reduce violence in its programs. The Illinois Democrat proposes a government study on TV violence and an exemption to the antitrust laws that would let broadcasters discuss TV violence together legally. Three theater critics who recommend plays for the Pulitzer Prize have sent a letter to the Pulitzer Board saying the only script they all agreed was Pulitzer quality was Woody Allen's screenplay for Hannah and Her Sisters. The critics want the Pulitzer Board to start considering movies for the Drama Award, which now only go to a play. No Pulitzer Prize for drama was awarded this year. Liz?
The song Crush on You is at number 4 on Billboard Magazine's latest black chart. And it's rising rapidly on the pop chart, now standing at number 44. Cheryl Washington introduces us to the band who recorded the tune.
The 8 brothers and sisters who comprise this group are called the Jets. They range in age from 12 to 20. The Tonkin family, living in Minneapolis, have a hot hit on their hands called Crush on You.
We've been working hard. It's almost our 9th year we've been working as musicians, and it took this long, and we believe that we've been working for this, and we deserve in a way, but in a humble way, we know that we still have more to go.
From an early beginning, the Jets were encouraged by their parents to perform. It paid off. Currently, they're on a Fresh Fest tour with major rap artists, plus there's talk of an imminent tour with Prince.
It's still working. We don't know what's going to happen. It's not confirmed or anything. But it would be nice.
What's also nice is their wholesome, genuine love for one another, which reflects in their music.
Your image is considered squeaky clean. Do you like that?
It's an advantage to be squeaky clean because you have nothing to worry about. You know, we're not alcoholics, but we're workaholics.
Like becoming spokespersons for the Missing Children program through their record company.
We're one of the first groups to start this campaign of putting those safety tips on those albums to help other families keep it together.
And keeping it together is just what the Jets are doing. Cheryl Washington, CNN, New York.
Reviews now of two new movies opening today nationwide. Bill Tush reviews the comedy Wise Guys, but first Dennis Michael reviews the fantasy film Legend.
Ridley Scott has made some amazingly visual films like Alien and Blade Runner, but his new and expensive fantasy Legend suffers from audiovisual overkill. That and some outside sabotage scuttles the story. Not that the story is all that difficult to scuttle. It's a fluffy fairy tale about the Prince of Darkness attempting to bring on eternal night by killing holy unicorns. About as difficult a story as the Care Bears movie. To produce atmosphere, Scott brings out all his tricks. Every shot has something in the air, either feathers or snowflakes or smoke. The studio imposed heavy cuts in the film. The result is murky, choppy, and mostly incomprehensible. The dialogue that remains is often impossible to understand due to loud sound effects and an even louder soundtrack, again imposed by the studio, from the synthesizer group Tangerine Dream. The usually magnetic Tom Cruise is completely forgettable here. The only good performance is by Tim Curry as the Lord of Darkness, buried under pounds of makeup.
Was it not your sin trapped the unicorn? Even now, the evil seed of what you have done germinates within you.
No.
At least I believe that's Tim Curry. Legend arrives at the theaters this weekend and will soon depart to a well-deserved Never Never Land. Dennis Michael, CNN, Hollywood.
I'm Bill Tosh in New York. In Wise Guys, Danny DeVito and Joe Piscopo play best buddies who work for the mob. The twosome are lower echelon mob, real lower echelon.
I always have plenty for you to do. Here.
It's your grocery list and your dry cleaning.
Harry, played by DeVito, and Moe, played by Piscopo, make a big mistake when they use the boss's money to bet on a horse. Guess what? Right, the horse loses. This gives the boss, played by Dan Hedaya, a chance to teach the two-timing twosome a lesson and deliver the film's only really funny line.
Do we really hurt them by killing them?
Harry and Moe get away and go on the lam in Atlantic City. DeVito does physical comedy, while Piscopo makes plenty of faces, neither of which has anybody in stitches. The only character that does get a few laughs is Frankie the Fixer, played by wrestler Captain Lou Albano. In his first feature role, he even gets to be funnier than the stars. But a supporting character, even one as big as Captain Lou, can't support the whole movie. Wise Guys comes across as Preetzy's honor goes slapstick. Bill Tosh, CNN, New York.
Well, that takes care of the movie reviews. A new play opened on Broadway last night. It's called Social Security. And Lee has a review of that. Lee, what do you think?
I liked it a lot. As a matter of fact, somewhere up in heaven, the late Ethel Barrymore must be smiling because the theater named in her honor is rocking with laughter.
Andrew Bergman's new comedy, Social Security, is easily the funniest play to open on Broadway this season, and it deserves a long run. Marlo Thomas and Ron Silver have their names above the title, but Joanna Gleason, Kenneth Welch, Olympia Dukakis, now isn't that one of the great names of all time, and Stephen Schnabel all deserve equal billing, as does director Mike Nichols. The plot of Social Security revolves around two couples. The wives are sisters. One couple, hip East Side New York. The other, squares from the suburbs. And what should they do with their aging, ill, and shrewish mother?
Well, I won't tell you the answer to that, but if there's an older parent living in your house, take him or her to see this play, because behind all the laughs, there's a message of hope shining through. When the Tony Award nominations are announced soon, don't be surprised to see several for this show and the people who are in it. Again, it's called Social Security, and it is a winner.
Starting next Monday, a new feature, the Showbiz Mailbox, will answer your questions on the air, so make sure that from now on when you write, you include your name and the city you live in. We'll try and answer any legit Showbiz question, but don't ask us for Don Johnson's home phone number. Our address, Showbiz Today, CNN 5, Penn Plaza, New York, New York, 10001. And we want to have a special thanks to our friends in Jamaica for all the cards and letters. For now, that's it for this edition of Showbiz Today. Be sure to join me Sunday for good news on Superstation WTBS. I'm Liz Wickersham.
What's Don Johnson's home phone number?
I love it.
And I'm Lee Leonard, and watch CNN this weekend for Showbiz This Week with Bill Tosh. We leave you now with a look at the Jetsons video. It's their new TV look for 1986, and for all of us here at Showbiz Today, have a good night and a very pleasant weekend. What was that number again?
Thank you.
eliminated. The humorous detective show Riptide runs on NBC right before The Last Precinct, a time slot it was moved to after losing in the ratings to ABC's Moonlighting. Tonight, Riptide pays homage to the show that knocked it off and pokes a little fun at Moonlighting and at itself. In tonight's episode, the Riptide Detective Agency is hired as technical advisors for a program similar to Moonlighting. Got it? Here's a clip.
Rosalind Grant, Carrie Russell, meet the men of the Riptide Detective Agency of King Harbor.
Hi, how are you?
How are you?
Yeah, for the next 7 days, they're going to show you what being a real private eye is really like.
Excuse me, there is one thing I don't understand. I thought you said that this series was about two struggling detectives who can barely make ends meet, right?
Yeah, isn't that novel?
Well, how can you afford such nice clothes? I don't understand that. And also this office, I mean, it must cost a fortune to rent and furnish a place like this.
1-800-USA-9000. Senator Paul Simon is introducing legislation intended to encourage the TV industry to reduce violence in its programs. The Illinois Democrat proposes a government study on TV violence and an exemption to the antitrust laws that would let broadcasters discuss TV violence together legally. Three theater critics who recommend plays for the Pulitzer Prize have sent a letter to the Pulitzer Board.
Hey, come on. You think people in Nebraska want to watch a show about people who dress like slobs and live on a boat? Hey, give me a break.
Still to come on Showbiz Today, we'll review Social Security on Broadway and wise guys in the movie theaters.
Next week, we'll look at the proliferation of TV weddings. All that and more on Showbiz Today.
And now back to Showbiz Today on CNN.
Some items in the Showbiz databank. Frank Sinatra says he sent a telegram to President Reagan congratulating him on the bombing of Libya. Sinatra says the telegram simply read, "Encore, encore, encore." You got 7 words left, Frank. MTV premieres Hands Across America video tomorrow as part of the project's National Sign-Up Day. Those who want to be part of the coast-to-coast human chain on Sunday, May the 25th, can sign up by calling toll-free